The 1999 Beloit College defense was known for its great speed, its ability to create turnovers, and its unrelenting desire to keep its opponent out of the end zone. A senior-laden group, the Buck defense was led by number 62, Matt Krill. The senior from Sumner, Washington, earned his third selection to the All-League team and was honored as Beloit's co-MVP, the conference's defensive MVP, and a member of the All-American team. Over his sparkling career, Krill's dominating play was characterized by his intelligence, physical conditioning, speed, and power. Senior defensive end Ryan Cullity received all-conference recognition for the second straight year. The Livonia, Michigan native was a four-year starter and finished among the college's career leaders in several defensive categories. Junior transfer Jim Castilla made the All-League team in his first year at Beloit. The cornerback from Gordon, Texas, led Beloit with 5 interceptions. Senior safety Chris Molnar completed a spectacular career at Beloit, being named to the All-Conference team for the 4th time and by being recognized as the Bucs' co-MVP. Molnar's tremendous football instincts, toughness, confidence, and speed made him one of the best defensive backs and return men in Beloit College football history.
That was awesome!
Again in 1999, the Beloit offense featured a quick strike pass attack and a pounding running game. The Buccaneer offense gained over 3,500 yards and scored 265 points. One of the Bucs' best rushing days came in their 47-13 win over Monmouth. Led by Nate Edwards' 136-yard and 4-touchdown performance, Beloit gained 493 yards on the ground. In their last four meetings, Beloit has outscored Monmouth 153-27. Controlling the football is always a big part of the Beloit game plan. Having the ball for nearly 40 minutes earned the Buccaneers a 31-14 win over Lawrence, the Bucs' 11th win over the Vikings in the last 12 years. On this day, Beloit's final drive consisted of 16 plays and 75 yards that consumed over 9.5 minutes without adding a meaningless touchdown. Winning the close ones has become a tradition at Beloit College. Locked in a 14-14 tie with Knox College late in the fourth quarter, the Bucs began their final drive at their own 14-yard line. 17 plays and 86 yards later, the Buccaneers culminated their 7-minute drive with the game-winning touchdown with only 30 seconds left on the clock. Beloit finished the season as the 13th best rushing team in the country, and three Buck linemen were named to the All-League team. Matt Nilsson, number 50, a sophomore transfer from Clinton, Wisconsin, played left guard and had a terrific inaugural season with the Bucks. Nilsson is an athletic pulling guard and a strong one-on-one run blocker. Dave Sager, number 66, the senior right guard from Freeport, Illinois, revitalized the Beloit offense when he moved from defensive to offensive line a year ago. Sager is one of the best pulling guards in the program's history. Senior Brent Johnson, number 77, concluded a great career at Beloit. The center was a four-year starter, and in 99, this Arkansas-Wisconsin native was voted the team's best blocker by his teammates. Junior Scott Dvorak, number 23, was the heart of the Beloit offense from his tailback position. A devastating blocker, Dvorak, along with the Buccaneer offensive line, cleared a path allowing Beloit to gain over 2,500 yards on the ground. The Huntley, Illinois native also proved to be a threat with the ball as he averaged over 5 yards per carry and pounded his way to nearly 600 yards on the ground.
Right about now, the Funk Soul Brother, check it out now. The Funk Soul Brother, right about now. The Funk Soul Brother, check it out now. The Funk Soul Brother, right about now. The Funk Soul Brother, check it out now. The Funk Soul Brother, right about now. The Funk Soul Brother, check it out now. The Funk Soul Brother, right about now. The Funk Soul Brother, check it out now. The Funk Soul Brother, right about now. The Funk Soul Brother, right about now.
Beloit College football closed out the 1900s with the most successful decade in the program's history. Beloit captured 5 Midwest Conference North Division titles and recorded more victories than in any other decade since Beloit first started playing football in 1889. As the pages in our calendar turn to a new century, Beloit College football celebrates the new Strong Stadium, one of the elite small college football venues in America, and a tradition of playing exciting, hard-hitting football.